All right, well, if you're going to ask any questions about architecture here in the city of Boston, William Young is probably a good guy to have in your corner. And if we're going to get into any architectural trivia, would you be on my team? Would you mind?
I'd be happy to, Chuck.
Well, thanks for coming here tonight. And certainly the events of Patriots Day obviously brought the community together, ironically. And, you being in the city all the time, I mean, what have you seen pre-Patriots Day and post-Patriots Day that kind of puts it all into perspective?
Well, I would say that the calamity, as acute as it was, reminded people of things that they always knew, which was that this is a very special place, that a lot of wonderful people live and work here, and that beyond the wonderful people who live and work here, much of New England really identifies with Boston and the Back Bay particularly, and Boylston Street and Newbury Street, because of all the you name it, all the restaurants, the salons, the galleries, all the shops, everyone ends up on one of those streets for major occasions in their life. Lunch before taking the grandkids to their first game at Fenway, getting your hair done before your wedding, buying an engagement ring, buying your first painting. So the Back Bay is really central not only to Boston, but also to New England's identity. And through a tragedy, it's become better known beyond the borders of New England. But it's reminded us of what we've known and appreciated for a very long time.
Now, I do a show called Life is Great New England, and we talk about the inspirational stories of people, places, and things here that make this such a great area. But what I figure is that people from all over the country are going to see the show, they're going to see things in clips like this and say, wow, what a cool place that is, maybe I'll come and visit. People all over the country and the world for that matter, they see pictures of Boston in magazines and they instantly, the architecture and the buildings just make it look a European feel. There's just something different about this, especially to our friends in New York City. It's such a stark contrast, but
right.
Boston is special, isn't it?
It's very special. 100 years ago and earlier, Boston was really the hotbed of architecture in the United States. And it was, Boston buildings were models for architects throughout the U.S. and also to a surprising extent, work that was being done by Boston architects 100 years ago were being imitated by European architects.
Mm-hmm.
So that really tells us something. And of course, 100 years ago, MIT, which was the first school of architecture in the United States, was located right on Boylston Street. So architects were being educated here and were practicing here. And today we get to enjoy their beautiful designs.
And before I let you go, I mean, the Boston is just, blossoming with new development. It's
yes.
Like the Seaport area. And, there's just so much new things that are happening.
Right.
Do you think it's going in the right direction? Do you feel that the attempt is being made to keep that same Boston character?
Well, developing a new area is always a challenge. But once upon a time, the Back Bay was a new area. It's all landfill that took 40 years to develop, and so in a way, it's an old story. It's unfamiliar to people who are around today, but in many ways, it's a new exploration of a very familiar theme. And Boston, like all thriving living things, knows how to reinvent itself.
Well, I hope you have a good time tonight. Enjoy yourself. Bid on a lot of cool things that are here.
Absolutely.
And I'm sure I'll see you probably out there on the dance floor cutting it up.
Very good, Chuck. Thank you so much.
Have a good night.
Good night. Thank you.